No one is perfect. Human error is almost inevitable. But some construction mistakes can end up costing millions of dollars to go down the drain. When it comes to engineering a building, there are a lot of considerations to be made even before the construction starts. There are countless hours invested into designing every last aspect to make sure that everything comes together just right. Not only does a building have to be functional, it also has to be able to withstand all sorts of different conditions that may arise. At the end of the day, nobody wants a building that is going to fall over. So, here are some of the most expensive construction mistakes to ever happen. If there are any construction mistakes which you know or have seen, then you can let us know in the comment section below this video. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button to subscribe to this channel, Inno Tutorial. The Sunsu Bridge over the Hans River links two South Korea districts. It is one of Seoul's most popular commuter roads. This 3,805-foot structure was struck by disaster in the morning of October 21, 1994. This bridge struggled under the weight of hundreds of people on their way to work in the early morning rush. Later at around 7:40 a.m., a 157-foot central chunk collapsed 65 feet into the river below along with cars, minibuses and a fully loaded bus. In the end, 32 people lost their lives while 17 more were injured. An investigation was launched to know what exactly led to the incident. It was said that before this collapse occurred, the bridge had already received complaints about unstable foundations which caused an unsteady swinging motion. The root cause was then identified as a construction failure. Reports stated that the steel trestle joint supporting the central suspension had been welded with an incorrect thickness of 8 mm rather than 10 mm. As a result of this mistake, the crucial connecting pins broke under the huge pressure. Although the bridge was designed to withstand a maximum of 36.3 ton weight per car, vehicles weighing 47.3 tons were also using this bridge to travel. These combined factors cost the state council $185,000 in compensation to the victims. Meanwhile, a complete rebuild of this bridge was set to cost an extra $2 million, making this bridge disaster one of the most expensive human error. In what is Israel's deadliest civilian disaster, the floor of the Fisai Wedding Hall in Jerusalem collapsed during the wedding of Keren and Asaf Dreor in 2001, dropping 23 attendees to their death and therefore injuring hundreds more. The event was captured on camera and broadcast internationally, spreading images of the horrific scene around the globe. Initially, people suspected terrorism, as noted by police at the scene, but an investigation quickly dispelled that concern. Witnesses described the floor sagging before the collapse. According to RS News, the main issue was the Parker building method, which is a cheap method of constructing lightweight concrete, which was banned shortly after the incident. Additionally, the building was originally designed in two halves, with one side only 2 stories and the other side 3 stories. Half of the third floor was only meant to be a roof and lacked structural strength. Partitions in the lower floor help handle the difference in load bearing, but the owners decided to remove the partitions shortly before the wedding. The floor sagged immediately, although the owners said it was because of cosmetic issues rather than structural issues. Following the disaster, the creator of the Parker method, Eli Ron, was arrested and convicted of 23 negligent deaths as well as negligent assault on the remaining victims. In spring of 2014, London welcomed an ambitious new skyscraper to its financial district. This 525-foot tall reflective building became known as the walkie-talkie due to its distinctive curved design. However, this shiny new tower was hiding a dark secret. During summertime, citizens of London began complaining that The building sat facing concave surface was causing strong rays of sunlight at a certain point in the day, which could raise temperature to an unheard of 70 degrees centigrade. This temperature caused a small fire on the doormat of a barber shop. It also melted a Jaguar SJ belonging to a local businessman. One journalist even attempted to fry an egg in the extreme heat. This shows you how hot it gets. The newly nicknamed walkie-talkie had to be stopped. So, a permanent sunshade known as Breeze Sulehi was attached to the building between the 3rd to 34th floor over the course of 6 months. Finally, it cost over $12 million, a hard pill to swallow, considering this building already cost over $250 million to build. Ironically, the architect Rafael Vinoli, who also designed the Vidara Hotel in Las Vegas, which suffered a similar problem, where it slightly burned some sunbathers, which earned the nickname the Death Ray. Vinoli even confessed that he knew this would happen, but he said he didn't have the tools to analyze just how bad it would be. As a result of this, people started saying, this guy needs to stop designing superpowers instead of buildings. The Lotus Riverside Complex in Shanghai was an ambitious project, but it ended in a complete disaster, all because of one simple mistake. The residential complex consists of 11 new high-rise apartment blocks, but at around 5 a.m. on 27 June 2009, one of the 13-story buildings suddenly collapsed. Luckily, it somehow missed the surrounding blocks, which would have created a devastating domino effect on the other blocks. The collapse killed just one construction worker. The fallout could have been much worse if the almost complete building had been occupied by its buyers. Investigators find out that the collapse was caused by non-compliance with construction standards and some seriously poorly designed foundations. The earth beneath the building was excavated to make a 15-foot underground car park, and the soil had been piled up 32 feet on a nearby riverbank. Due to this, it burst under the pressure, sending water gushing beneath. These muddy foundations caused the building to topple over to the south. Simply moving the earth to a different location could have prevented this whole incident. Because of this disaster, a number of project investors requested and withdrew their money back. The company suffered a total economic losses of up to $30 million. This amount includes construction costs and compensation to the homeowners of the $2,100 per square meter apartment. Also known as Galloping Getty, the Tacoma Narrow Bridge in Washington collapsed only 4 months after opening for public use. The bridge spanned the nearly mile-wide Puget River, making it the third longest suspension bridge in the world, behind the Golden Gate Bridge and the George Washington Bridge. But its length was not what made the bridge so famous, which continues to fascinate engineers and physics professors till this day. What made it so famous was that, under even moderate wind speed, the bridge would continue to have up and down movement like a sine wave. Construction workers noticed problematic bulking even while building the bridge, leading to its famous nickname. While the original designer intended to create greater stability with a more standard design, the cost was so astronomical, around $200 million in today's money. So, instead of that, a cheaper option using place girders was used. Although the girders were only one-third the height of the originally proposed trusses, which resulted in a disproportionate depth-to-width ratio. As a result of this, the bridge was extremely flexible and vulnerable to high wind speed. When a 40-mile-per-hour wind struck on November 7, 1940, the bridge started to twist and bulk widely. The bridge finally gave way, snapping the supporting cables and dropping into the river below, causing a catastrophic collapse. So, these are some of the most expensive construction mistakes ever made. Which one of these construction mistakes do you think was a hard pill to swallow to both the designers and the architect? If you know of any construction mistake which was not mentioned in this video, or which construction mistake you have seen which was not mentioned in this video, let us know in the comment section below. And before you leave, please consider subscribing to this channel in a tutorial and click the bell notification icon to get more construction videos like this. And with that being said, you all have a good and a wonderful day. God bless you. Bye bye.